much the same manner as we do today. Christmas was coming, and people were getting excited and busily getting ready to celebrate the birth of the King of Kings and the Savior of the world. Let's peek into one of the village homes where the Weiss family is enjoying an evening together.
This is my favorite time of the year. Everything is so beautiful and exciting.
Yes, this is a special holy time. I always enjoy the beautiful organ music and the Christmas concert especially.
Oh, yes. Remember the beautiful cantata last year? I can almost hear it now.
Thank you, ladies. Everything's looking quite nice. Well, that snowstorm was a real killer. Far too early in the season for so much snow. Certainly hope it clears up before services.
Well, Pastor, the Christmas music is the highlight of the season. Surely the Lord wouldn't snow that service out. What good would that do?
Well, we don't always see the Lord's purposes right away, Mrs. Mueller. We see them in His own good time. Speaking of which, you know the Steiner baby has arrived yet?
I don't think so, but it's day to day now. We'll stop by on our way home to church today.
Thank you, ladies. That's all. Thank you.
As the ladies leave, Pastor Moore stares out of the church window with a look of concern on his face. If the weather were bad for Christmas, the mountain people couldn't get into the small village and to the church for services. Pastor Moore gathers up his things and goes outside into the cold winter evening. As the door closes behind him, a young mouse emerges from the recesses of the sanctuary and cavorts about the platform. Seeing the Christmas tree, it takes a tentative nibble. Then a couple of munchies. Next, it scampers toward the organ and takes an exploratory taste. Then the more, and settles down for a tasty. Down to play.
we've got this.
What about the Christmas program? We have to have more events than 2 weeks.
Well, I think we could send someone to Augsburg. They have a part there. I'll go with Mrs. Harris. I have a strong horse and a sturdy wagon.
I'll see anything else we can do. But you're not to go if it's too stormy. You wouldn't make it. Sorry, folks.
Oh, yeah.
Oh,
yeah. It's
cold.
Oh, yeah.
Come on over. I'll make some coffee.
Okay.
Town to register.
there were shepherds living out in the field nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. The angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone down around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is Christ, the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You'll find a baby wrapped in cloth and lying in a manger." Suddenly a great company of heavenly hosts appeared to the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to men on whom his favor rests." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let's go to Bethlehem and see the thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about." So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby who was lying in the manger. When they had seen him, they spread the word concerning what had been told them about this child, and all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds said to them. After Jesus was born in Bethlehem in Judea, during the time of King Herod, Magi from the east came to Jerusalem and asked, "Where is the one who has been born, the King of the Jews?" They saw a star in the east and had come to worship him. When King Herod heard this, he was disturbed, and all Jerusalem with him. When he had called together all the people, the chief priests and teachers of the law, he asked them where the Christ was to be born. "In Bethlehem of Judea," they replied, "for this is what the prophet has written: that you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah. Out of you will come a ruler who will be the shepherd of my people Israel." Then Herod called the Magi secretly and found out from them the exact time the star had appeared. He sent them to Bethlehem and said, "Go and make careful search for the child. As soon as you find him, report to me so that I too may go and worship him." After they had heard the king, they went out of their way, and the stars that they had been, that they had seen in the east went ahead of them, until they stopped at the place where the child was. When they saw the star, they were overjoyed. On coming to the house, they saw the child with his mother Mary, and they bowed down and worshipped him. Then they opened their treasures and presented him with gifts of gold and of incense and of myrrh.
Jesus, let down his sweet head. The stars do
small German church. Both Joseph Moore and Franz Brunner lived out their lives and died in relative obscurity, known only to God and to those with whom they ministered. But God intervened, and Silent Night has been sung throughout the entire world, translated into dozens of languages, and beloved by people everywhere.
Thank you.
Please rise. Let's get excited about our Lord. Let's just have joy in this house this morning.
By the prophet of old. God prepares a birth announcement